If you are a Microsoft 365 subscriber who recently added on Microsoft's new Copilot Pro license, I bet you are excited to start using it. But what happens when you log into Office and you either can't find that Copilot button? Or what if when you have the Copilot button, you enter a prompt, but it gives you an error message, something about your license, or something about, I can't do this right now, try again later. Or even worse, what if you enter a prompt and it tells you pulling things together for a very, very long time? It's almost like, is it connected to anything? I don't know. It should not be taking this long. If any of these issues are bugging you, don't worry, I've got you covered. In this video, I'll walk you through some common issues like these and show you how to fix them. Now, the first thing that you will want to check is to make sure you are signed in with the correct Microsoft account. If you're like me, you have multiple accounts, one for business, one for school, and your own personal one. I have Copilot on my personal Microsoft 365 license, and I gotta tell you, switching back and forth between all the various licenses, that can get confusing. So just take your mouse, click on your profile picture, and make sure you have the correct account selected. Once you know you do, just try out a simple prompt with Copilot to see if it works. Now, if that doesn't resolve your problem, I'm going to stop this real quick. The next step is to install any updates that you might have for that specific Microsoft account. Let me show you what I mean. So let's go up to our File menu, and I'm going to go all the way down to Account here. Now, displayed on the right-hand side of the screen under Product Information Microsoft, you should see the license that's attached to this machine. If you're like me and have multiple licenses, click on the Show Additional Licensing Information to expand all of your options. Now, if the specific subscription product that you have Copilot for has updates next to it, for example, I've got this Update Now button next to this specific license, that means you have updates to install for Office. Go ahead, click that Update Now button. Microsoft will then check for updates, and you can continue working in the background while it installs those updates, or you can simply close that app. Microsoft will then download those updates and install them on your machine. And this can take a few minutes, so just be patient as that takes place. Eventually, you should see the Applying Updates screen appear. When updates are finished installing, you should see a message that looks just like this. Updates were installed. Go ahead, close that window and open one of your Microsoft apps. I'm going to open up Microsoft Word. Opening up a blank document. There's Copilot. Let's try another prompt one more time. And there you go. You can see it's creating some content in that background. So on my machine, it is working now. But let's say you can't even see the Copilot button, or that Copilot button isn't activated, so you can't even try out a prompt. If that's the case, then you might try saving your document to OneDrive. In certain Microsoft Office applications, for example, in Microsoft Excel, autosave must be turned on in order to use Copilot, which means that file must be saved to OneDrive. And what I mean by that is the OneDrive associated with the Copilot license. Otherwise, that Copilot button will be shaded a light gray. So let's go ahead, click that Save button, and let's save that book to just OneDrive. I'm going to title this Test. Now that that file is saved to OneDrive, you can see that autosave is turned on and that Copilot button appears. When I click on that Copilot button, that Copilot preview pane will show up on the right-hand side, and I can try any one of these prompts. For example, if I wanted to auto-generate an Excel table with fake data for me, let's click on Try an Example, and it inputs that data or that table for me. So Copilot is working now. Now, if you have tried all of those options, you are signed into the correct account, You have gone into the account area and you have downloaded all those updates. There's one more thing that you can try if it's not working, and that's to update your license. So go back to File, click on Update License, and then sign in to verify your subscription. Another window will prompt up asking you to activate Office. Go ahead and log in with your email and your password. And once you've done that, you'll see this message, almost there. Please restart any open Microsoft 365 apps to continue. And that goes for the one I'm working in right now. And any additional Microsoft Office applications you have open. So if you've got Word open or Outlook, you gotta close those as well. With all of those apps closed, just click on any old app one more time to try it out. I'm going to open up a blank document and then try a simple prompt just to test it one more time. And there it is. You can see it has generated some information following my prompt. From there, I can choose to keep it or refresh, delete, or try another keyword to refine what Copilot gave me. But I'm just going to click keep it for now. Now, if you've tried all of those steps, you've signed in with the correct Microsoft account, you've installed updates, you've refreshed that license or activated that license, you've closed your apps, you've reopened them. If you've done all of that and nothing works, one last thing to do, and that is to give some feedback to Microsoft. Click that Report a Problem button. And now, in this window, describe the problem in detail, what you expected to happen, and what actions you took to try to resolve that problem. This will help Microsoft fix any issues and make Copilot better. In the meantime, if you have any additional questions, be sure to leave a comment below and check out the links in the comment section. If this video helped you, be sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel for more office productivity tips.